It's an entire 3 months since the last real life video. What has been going on? What new crazy developments have happened here? Am I still alive? Yes. Is my hair ugly? Yes, I got a haircut. They cut it too much. Half this video is going to be with my old good looking styling hair. Half it's going to be with this lesbo hair. I don't know what to call it. It's kind of nasty. But what else has been happening here? Well, in terms of new developments, I got a table to hold a TV that I got. TVs are like stupid cheap now. So is VR. That's what this video is. That one's this video. Oh, I plugged up my Switch. I already had the Switch though. We got a couch to go with the television. It was $75 off of Craigslist, and I think there was only like two cockroaches in it. Good value. Good stuff. What else here? We got all the crap underneath. Oh yeah, and I went to Goodwill and I bought some DVDs, you know, just some of the classics, you know, Taken, just all the really classic stuff, you know, Garfield the movie, you know, the good stuff. And probably most importantly, I got my hand on a little bit of an anime figure. I won't lie, it wasn't perfect shipping, but it was like $3.19, not even. It did come with the other guys and the coffin itself. I'm just keeping this guy on my desk. Honestly, this guy alone is worth like $3.19, much less all the other crap. I might end up getting a plastic baseboard and like gluing them to it, because as it currently stands, they can't all stand. It just doesn't work. But I mean, this guy's good enough. This guy's worth it. Enough people know the meme that it's funny.
Guess who got a frickin' package, boys? I'll give you a hint. It's not your grandma. It's not your granddad. It's nothing like that. Your boy got a package. If you guys have been on the Twitter or on the Discord, you guys know what this is. If you guys haven't, then freaking just get on my Twitter and my Discord, idiots. Be a supreme gamer, so that way you're up to speed on all things, instead of just being a behind gamer like you are right now. What this is the Oculus Quest 2, the pretty much cheapest VR headset on the market currently that can still actually connect and isn't like fucking Google Cardboard. We're not counting that shit. But yeah, this is very much aimed for the common consumer. And in this video, I'm going to be asking just that question: is VR actually consumer ready yet, or is it still a little bit niche and like you gotta be a little bit of a specialist? We'll see. This product, if anything, should be the changer for that. It's only like $350, like all in, to buy like all the hardware they need for it. So it's just real quick, boop, bop, bada bing, boop, bada bop, boom, pow, pow, boom. Oculus. Let me scooch. Oculus Quest 2, brought to you by Facebook. Thank God it's brought to you by Facebook. That was a joke. I don't really mind too much though. I mean, realistically, I don't know what Facebook really plans to do with my information if they have it. Plus also, it's not like suddenly all of my Facebook friends, which are all just family members, are suddenly going to be informed of all the things that I'm doing in virtual reality. That's just not how it's going to work. The fact that it makes you log in there is kind of weird, but that just is what it is. I'm looking for a little lip. Oh. Bap? Is this how we take off the packaging? Oh, it's one of these. Oh. Oh. Let's take you all the way out of frame, but look at this. Just clean right down the center, no need for a knife. You need a knife for the packaging, obviously, still, but... Ooh, a very pristine and clean box. With only a few nicks in the corners. A lot better than that, than those figures that you guys just saw. Those were mucho damaged. These are only just barely damaged. So does it just slide out? Oh, it does. It's one of them little slidey boys. So this side of my room is just gonna be completely filled with crap by the end of this, but that's just how it is. Got some nice plastic that's really cold because it's pretty much winter out here. And then we have the actual contents. Wow, crazy. Yeah, these are all very much cold to the touch right now, because it's it's cold currently outside here in this Wisconsin weather. So these will obviously all heat up, but yeah, we got your left, your right controllers. The box, I don't know what peripherals this includes, because I did not buy their, I think it was $80 for their Steam, or not their Steam link, but whatever, like the PC link. Instead, I bought a $20 third-party one that they literally suggested the Oculus store, so I saved like $60, it was 5 feet less long. Who really cares, it was a $20 cable. I'm glad that I went with that over buying their like $80 cable, whatever it is. So I don't know what's in this box, we'll have to real quick see. And then the actual headset, which is very snugly put in here, which is nice, so it doesn't fall out and stuff. And I'm assuming I'm gonna keep this box, I guess, maybe? I mean, I might as well, I have the space for it. Just keep it here, just so that way I have some place to put it all. That's kinda nice looking, I guess. Also, it came with a little eye rest thing that you have to attach it, but whatever. What's in the box? Instructions. Oh, and it does actually come with a USB Type-C to see this, presumably, well, first off, it's too short to use to actually link to your PC, but also, I'm assuming it doesn't actually have that high of data transfer, so I guess if you just didn't have a USB C to C charger, you'd have one, which would be a good thing, because maybe not everyone has one. And then, is this just, like, paperwork nonsense? Yeah, just paperwork nonsense. Okay. So everything that you'd assume to have in a piece of technology, to be here. It's now all unboxed. Let's just hop right into it, lads. Okay, this is to look at the record button. I have to look up like this so my eyes can see, but it asked me to adjust the lenses. This is like as clear as it can get. There's three different settings. I don't know which one's actually clear. They all looked pretty dang clear to me. I might need to get my eyes checked. I need to flip these as well. But they all looked clear enough to me, so I'm not really gonna to bother with it anymore. Let's just keep on going with the setup here. And eventually I should be able to actually record and show you guys. Please stay seated for setup. It did recommend you stay seated. Well, luckily for them, my ass is lazy and I was gonna sit as much as I could this video. Little did they know. Wi-Fi, they're searching for Wi-Fi network, so I'm gonna log into my Wi-Fi. Okay. Can I choose you? Nope. I don't know how to actually select. Before it just let me kind of mouse over stuff. Can I select? Yeah, my Wi-Fi is password protected. Can I select you? Which one's the select button? What? Okay, it wants me to use A, I didn't know that. And now I gotta do this. Actually, this is my, whatever. I won't lie, the text is not the clear, so this might actually be a good time to actually test which one would be best for my eyes. That's pretty blurry. And that is the least blurry. Yeah, okay, so this one actually is the best. Limited connection. Well, that's just gonna have to suffice for now. Network details. I mean, you need better Wi-Fi than that? Are we not just good to go? I guess there's more to figure out. Hold up here a second, lads. I don't know why I was being so stupid. So now, it's given me an ad for the Oculus Quest. I mean, I don't need this. I'm already using your product, idiot. You already sold me. You're not gonna get no repeat customer. Ah, scheiße. Yeah, this is definitely a good time to be putting on the straps. I knew I was gonna put on the straps before I explained this little ad. I'm gonna real quick put on my little strap skis. Oh, what the hell happened? For a second there, just reset my lenses, which is weird because you should have to touch it physically, it shouldn't move on its own, there's no motor rest. I think I just bumped it or something. So yeah, we got the... Did I put the wrong strap on? No, I didn't put the wrong strap on, but I did put it on too tight. I don't want to cut no circulation. I just want to stay safe. I'm just trying to stay safe. I'm not trying to ruin circulation. Ah. Okay, it wants me to read the health and safety guide. If the Wii has taught me anything, it's never read the health and safety guide. That's what Wii has taught me. Your headset is being updated to the latest software. Can we move it over here? Okay, thank God. You can remove your headset. Keep your headset charging and play a sound when the update is complete. Oh. I mean, it's downloading one or two updates, so I'm just gonna keep it on while it's updating. It's updating real fast. There's not much left here. So it took just over 4 minutes to get the Oculus Quest all set up to start playing stuff on the Oculus Quest store. Not bad. Anyway, let's get into me being goofy in my first time in VR. My hairpin turn coming up. I mean, that was pretty cool. Boom, are we recording? Are we here? I do believe we are now here. I don't know where here is. Yeah, I believe that we're here. This is the actual Facebook whatever system. There, you guys know my first name. Holy shit, you guys can pretty much dox me at this point. So I think we're just gonna try out one free application or two. We're not gonna buy any applications yet, because I still wanna try out Steam today. But I wanna try an actual game, not just something. More apps from your apps. Where's... Can you just give me a video game? Can you just give me a free video game? Is there a search by price? There's gotta be at least some free software out here, like premium software. Please, I really don't have to buy anything just yet. I'm eventually probably gonna get a few applications on this on this OS, but I plan to mostly stick to Steam just because I already have a big library there. Here, we can get some demos. Sure, let's get a demo of Super Hot. Sure. I did get only the 64GB version because, once again, I was planning largely to keep it plugged into my actual PC to actually do. I'm putting it on my PC. You guys can't see it here, but. Well, you guys can't see it in the camera either. As far as you guys know, I don't even own a PC. But yeah, the game plan was I was going to put it in my. Let's put it mostly in my PC, so I grabbed the smaller gigabyte version because it was like $100 cheaper. And I'm also someone who doesn't really mind having to uninstall stuff off my console to install new stuff, typically, most of the time. So yeah, it's only 64GB. Hopefully we can actually store all the footage, as well as also actually get into the games. So it looks like it's already done installing. We're playing Super Hot. Are we doing this? Hold A and X. I don't know which one the X button is, that one. At the same time. I won't lie, I get very, very close to my safe space very, very fast. Maybe I should have made it a little bit bigger. It's fine, though. But yeah, I'll definitely want to get a little more space. Oh, he's dead now. Time moves when you move. Okay, is that... Oh, that was the first level. Okay. Very intuitive controls, by the way. I didn't tell me the controls, I just kind of figured it out. So am I allowed to just punch this guy? What am I doing? No, I guess there's no guns. I just have to shoot these boys like normal. Okay. Oh. Boop. Boop. Okay. I'm just gonna move my arms to make him get closer because I really don't want to waste that much time. It's like I'm doing a little fucking running animation. Wow. Oh, I wanted to just call someone on the radio. Sure, easy enough. I will say why this is moving slowly, I just want to say the stereo is actually pretty nice on these things, or the audio, whatever you want to call it. least I think it's pretty good. It's pumping out some very, very nice stereo audio left and right. Is that even anywhere close to him? Not really. Well, I guess. Oh, there's a freaking whole wall of shurikens here. Oh, it wanted me to throw him like a tomahawk, I see. Well, that's a little bit high. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna wanna rechange my play space to make it a little bit more big. Oh, we barely clipped his arm, but we did technically get him there. Let's go. But yeah, this is working completely fine. And this is took me less than an hour to set up. So realistically, you know, this isn't... Well, now I'm facing my AC, right? No, I just looked down for a second. Yeah, I will say, you can see out of the headset, but I think that's what all VR headsets do. I'm gonna be honest, I haven't used a VR headset in a really long time. That's kind of nice, that way I can know what the hell I'm facing. There we are, we touched... Ow. But yeah, this took like less than an hour to set up, and I'm already on a demo version of Super Hot. Overall, definitely gets... I can't show it here, so I'll show it here. It gets two big old thumbs up. Good with my hands. So yeah, I think I'm gonna be... done recording this little bit. I think I'm gonna do... You know what? We'll keep on going with this. I was gonna say that we're gonna be done recording. I'll just put this part at the end of the video, I guess. Oh, please. Oh, this guy was closer to me. Okay, well, I guess I'm just stupid. Alright, epic. Oh, I guess I dodged that? Or I put my hand up in front of it or something like that. My hand's just not having a good time here now, is it? Oh, you bastard. I mean, it can only hit where my headset is, it can't hit where my actual body is, right? So it's a lot easier to dodge. Than an actual Super Hot. Yeah, I won't lie, this play space is a little bit small. This has just got to be the most goofy thing, having to move your hand to have time actually move forward. Because before you could just press like A and S, right? I just got completely decked. Anyway, I think we're going to call it quits for the time being here, ladies and gentlemen. Just temporarily. So next up, I decided to connect the Oculus Quest to the PC using the Oculus Link cable from Amazon that I bought that I was talking about, and play Project Cars 2. Project Cars 2 is a game that I play a lot that has integrated VR support. It's probably the game that I played the most that has VR support that I just haven't used VR on. And I specifically played it on a track that I've played a lot with a vehicle that I played a lot, that being the Evo 9 on California Highway. So this track has a lot of emotional value for me because I've done it so many times. I understand how the track feels in this car with this setup. So this is my first time playing through it in VR. I didn't end up having my webcam at the file, didn't end up working correctly. As well as also the audio is a little bit messed up. And during that time, I had to kind of cut forward. Basically, what I was talking about right before this clip started was about how, because the Oculus Link functionality wasn't fully updated for the new Quest 2, it was still using the Quest 1, essentially there was a lower refresh rate and a lower resolution inside the headset. You guys won't see that. You guys will see what my PC saw. But that problem that I'm talking about no longer exists. Since me editing this video, it's been updated for Oculus Quest 2, meaning that it can fully utilize the entire resolution of the Quest 2's bigger resolution and the bigger refresh rate. So there's no worries there. That's what we're cutting into me saying. Let's get into me playing a car game in virtual reality. So anyway, let's now actually go and let's get it all off. But so far it looks, even with the slightly lower resolution, which once again can be fixed, but even at slightly lower resolution, it's still more than just looking at it on a monitor, and the refresh rate is still slightly higher than my normal monitor. This is 75Hz, my monitor that I use is 60Hz, so in theory this is a technical better display to be able to play video games with, But yeah, now my head isn't clipping through anything. I can kind of see everything around me. I can even use the rear view mirror. Although I have a rear view mirror up here as well. I might want to turn that off, or maybe I just want to... Oh, I'm going to real quick turn off heads up display. HUD layouts. HUD layouts. Is there any way just to turn them all off? I always forget this. Okay, yeah, no, we'll say this is good enough. So I'm now good to set off. I'm in first, I'm getting on the brakes. And yeah, we're good to set off. It's gotta be said, it is, I've started, oh, hello, see, I've played this game so much, but to actually see it all in front of me is something else, quite interesting. Obviously this game's kind of old. It wasn't even that graphically impressive at the time. I knew it was a little bit graphically impressive at the time. Plus also, I'm at a lower resolution than what's possible, but this is still very, 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 very amazing compared to not being able to do this at all. So yeah, let's just get right into it, I guess. Oh man, we are zooming, holy. Oh, don't crash the car. Whew. Well, remember what I just said about don't crash the car? We'll just real quick restart. Just because I was right at the beginning of the course. But I mean, I felt pretty confident to go, not super slow, I feel like I can go a little bit fast. Not too fast, but a little bit fast. Whew. Oh man, look at that sunrise. A hairpin turn coming up. I mean, that was pretty cool, not very good, but it was definitely cool, and I can look down at my feet, I can look at my rev limiters. We stuttered there for like a second. Alright, well, we didn't end up hitting anything, but we did end up not being very fast. Yeah, the lower resolution and the slight stutter dropping is not the greatest, but it's... I can probably optimize a little bit better. Boy. Anyway, let's head on up. Definitely starting to get a little bit of motion sickness, not much yet, but just a little bit. At 113 miles an hour. Stuff is starting to stutter more and more as we get down the course, but this is pretty quick, pretty nice experience. Cool. I can honestly realistically turn off the hood because I can actually use the rev limiter on the car, like in like the in-car model. I could do that before. But man, oh man, I'm not going too slow. I will say that. And also, I typically do my runs during like the night in-game setting. Which means that this is whatchamacallit. This is a lot easier to see than during night, obviously, because night it's really, really dark. But yeah, that's not my start breaking point. That was a little bit early, but it's fine. I mean, where's Zimmin? That's definitely not supposed to take that corner, but it looked cool. It looked flashy. You know? Sometimes that's what it's all about, is just looking cool. we definitely broke a little bit weird there. It's fine though. Recovered. Oh, this is the corner that you're supposed to be looking at, and I decided to look up at the at how much percentage we had done. That was a bad time to look at stuff. And our run doesn't count anymore. I'm not surprised we went over a lot of dirt right there. But yeah, so now we're almost done with all the little twisties and turnies. We should be getting on to more of a straightaway. Doesn't necessarily feel new. I definitely am working through the course in the same way that I would any other time, but I definitely am experiencing it in a new way. It definitely doesn't feel the same. Probably a wheel and pedal set would probably make this game feel more different than virtual reality, but this still definitely makes the game feel a little bit, not necessarily new, but just different, like familiar type of different. But yeah, we're about to get in the really, really big speed section. Hopefully I can keep the foot down a little bit here. Ooh, that was tight. Definitely not the fastest exit, but cool exit nonetheless. And yeah, now we're really getting some crazy speeds. Should be hitting just under 150 miles per hour at the end of the straight. Is gonna be obviously mucho fast. Obviously you can see some of the game kind of slowing down there. It's not exactly the most smooth thing, but this is pretty dang fast, if I do say so myself. Ooh. And I think after this I'll do one run in some type of open wheel car, like a car that doesn't have a roof on it, so that way you can see a little more of the environment. This one's obviously pretty limiting, but this is obviously a car that I use a lot, so it has a lot of emotional significance to me. That was a pretty slow exit, by the way, relatively. I mean, it was fast for bots, that was probably really, really fast, but for me, that was a pretty slow exit. But yeah, I won't say too disoriented, but I'm a little bit disoriented. Obviously, my ears are saying that I'm moving really, really fast, and my eyes are saying that I'm moving really, really fast, but the part of my ears that detect movement knows that I'm just standing still. But not too disoriented. I think my eyes still kind of know that this is fake. Well, obviously I know it's fake, but like, I don't know, they're not throwing too many mind games at me. Here's hill number one. I shouldn't have to shift. Yeah, I should be fine not to shift. And ooh. That was quite some feeling. I'll run a little bit slower here. There's a really, really fast way to do this last section. It's like last 80-ish, 20-ish percent. But I'm just gonna do it in a slow way just to make sure I don't crash the car, because I haven't crashed the car yet this run. Because he's clean. I mean, I am clean, but I'm not very fast. But it is what it is. I'm not too worried about being stupid fast. This is quite a fun experience. Definitely not the fastest way to get over that hill, but... And then the last hill. Now it is just a straightaway until the finish. Look at those guardrails on the side. Look at the stop sign right here. I should stop looking at the signs and I should start looking at the road. Even though it's a straightaway, I can still mess up. It's difficult too, but I still can. let off the gas a little bit. And we'll get back on it. Okay, well, there we are. 8 minutes and 13 seconds. Definitely not my fastest run, definitely not my slowest run, though. Overall, I'm pretty good. I will real quick view the replay and save it. Just for comparison real quick, I kind of want to go back to whatchamacallit and see, I want to go back and see what my best record is, my best run, if you will. So I believe in time trials, Mitsubishi, California Highway Full, my current best time is 7 minutes 45, so that was about 23 seconds longer. I mean, honestly, not that bad. I know every single point that I got slower, and it's not like there was like too much just random slowness. When I was stepping down on the pedals, it felt like I was stepping down just as much as I would normally. Let's try out, let's go to Long Beach. Long Beach. And let's try out this thing, this little track car here. And we'll see how this feels in VR. Honestly, if anything, I have more of a headache than a like motion sickness, and that's probably just from the actual display constantly going onto my eyes, because I already have pretty bad eyes. You know, I stay up really, really late. I only sleep for a few hours every single night, and I spend too long looking at computer screens, so this isn't obviously going to make it any better, but go, go, go. Here we are. I'm going to step back a little bit for this car, I feel. Maybe not that much, maybe like this much. But yeah, the one big problem with this car going in first person before was that mirror right there. You couldn't see around it very well, but now with this kind of 3D effect, I should be able to corner a little bit better, in theory. Yeah, I got a warning for unsafely crossing the pit, which is fine. I'm not trying to set any world record, it's just how the pit is set up. Man, I can look on the inside and stuff for the turns. This is really useful. I don't know about useful, but it's definitely, it's useful if you only have one monitor. Definitely not the fastest buddy around that corner. But here we are. Oh, mega speed. Oh my god. Yeah, definitely not how this car is meant to be handled, but that's kind of like, we don't really care how the car is meant to be handled. We'll handle it our own way. Ludicrous speed. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay. Hard brake. Once again, really not how this car is meant to be treated. We're gonna be able to avoid the crash though, luckily. Ooh. Man, the sun glare. Anyway, we should be able to now. Dude, it makes hairpins actually a little bit easier, I won't lie, if I was fully utilizing the headset's capabilities. We are at full speed. I didn't see that curve very well, that's my bad. Kind of broke a little bit too late, but that's fine. Man, this just feels really good to go fast. Cool. Yeah, after playing on all these circuits and all these tracks for so long, and playing with all these different cars for so long, even though I'm still inputting my inputs the same way with the controller, viewing it all differently is definitely a little bit crazy, and that crash was a little bit crazy. I just crashed over there. I was going to, I was going to go all the way to that really, really long straightaway, and I was going to crash, but it looks like I've already crashed for myself. So let's, I was trying to do a really cool donut there, and I just kind of failed. Let's just real quick go to that long straightaway, and I'm just gonna real quick crash the car and see how that feels. Obviously, I just crashed right there, but I wanna see. I wanna go from as fast a speed as possible to absolutely nothing and see how that feels just crashing at such a high speed. We'll see. It should definitely feel quite interesting. Man, it's crazy. I just turned my head to see how well to turn the car. That's kind of insane. I mean, I know it sounds like so simple, but there I go, crashing the car again. Right. computer, just focus on getting to the straightaway. Gosh darn it. I was just messing with turning around, because so far I've just been kind of standing still. The part where you turn around, that's where it gets kind of crazy, because you can actually look into your corners and see how the hell you want to turn. Like right here, we're just gonna weep. Anyway, zoom. Again, not really taking these corners very elegantly. I was taking these corners, I was testing out these exact same car track combos yesterday, just with my normal display. And I was definitely doing the corners a lot better than I'm doing them right now. It's gotta be said. Here we are, that corner is pretty alright. Except for the fact that we kind of skid there during the entire corner, but other than that, it's pretty alright. Anyway, let's get ready for this good exit. That was a pretty alright exit, I kind of skidded out at the end. But yeah, let's get up to speed as fast as we can. I forgot to shift up. I was looking at all the buildings, I hit the wall. It's fine, we're still going pretty fast. Yeah, I'm just gonna go right into the crash barrier and see how it feels. Actually wasn't that dramatic. That was actually pretty.
We think you need to come into the
okay.
Pit. It looks like you've got some suspension damage, so we need to check it out, see if
doing,
we can fix it.
Doing donuts is what's really causing me some, I don't necessarily say issues, but that's what's really causing me any type of motion sickness. I don't know if it just has to do with the lower resolution or what it is, but yeah, that's definitely what's throwing me off the most is
you've got some
turning around
damage.
Whack like this.
The lap times start getting drastically.
But let's be done with this, and I think to end it off, I was deciding between doing go-karts or doing something with rally, and I think I'm going to do a rally one instead, because rally is pretty crazy, pretty exciting. So let me real quick pick us a rally car. Let's go with a Civic, sure, why not? And let's real quick find a... Let's find a interesting... This one's pretty fun. This is a very fun rally course. So yeah, let's just do a few laps of rally in a Honda Civic. But I will say, definitely a little bit weird feeling. I don't think I'll be faster quite yet with this, but I can definitely see this actually overall improving my lap times because I can actually see around the corners instead of just having to move the joystick in kind of a weird woggly way. So let me move this way a little bit so I'm not inside the netting. And yeah, I think we're good enough to go. So I will say, rally cars are pretty cramped, so this is actually decently immersive, believe it or not. So yeah, let's just kinda go. Oh man, these things pull a lot harder than those other two cars, I'll tell you that. Definitely not how we're supposed to take this corner. But yeah, no, these cars pull a hell of a lot harder. You know what, I am gonna, specifically for this, just because it's already so cluttered, I am gonna actually take the time to disable the heads-up display. Okay, yeah. Oh, it didn't save. What the? Heads up display. Alright, whatever. I guess it's just gonna stay like this. That's fine. Anyway, let's get back out there. I definitely should have held down the handbrake a little bit longer there. Ooh, these things pull. Oh. Oh. Oh god, we're off. Okay, that's fine. Let's not worry about that. There we are, there's a decent corner. We went very wide there. We were just wide on the exit, or on the entry even. Man, rally feels, ooh. Man, rally's something in VR. It's very, very mucho quick. Lots of bumps and stuff. Oh, I just have almost no perception of speed. When I was playing this on a monitor yesterday, it wasn't that bad, but I have almost no perception of my actual speed. I don't know if it has to do with how cramped the cockpit is or the display, but yeah, I'm just having a hard time gauging how fast I'm going and whether or not I'll clear these corners. Oh. There we are. There we are. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, that corner was almost really cool. Oh, look at this, we're like counter-steering. Oh, almost. Alright, let's take the Joker this time. Let's take the Joker section of the rally course. Oh, dude. Oh, god. This feels kind of insane. Oh, we've definitely got a little bit of starter there. That's fine, though. We actually turned that pretty well just because our car was sideways the entire time. Definitely not how you want to do the course, but that's how I did it. That's how it works. Oh, and now we're bumping all over the place. All right, let's just do one last final lap, and then I think we'll call it quits for the time being with Project Cars 2. Oh. Oh god. Yeah, okay, we're after that we're definitely gonna call it quits. Yeah, we're gonna call it quits for now. Let's see what I have to say. So first off, I'm going to be talking about the experience in the Oculus OS itself. The actual operating system that launches with the headset, fully works inside the headset, and is an all-in-one package. And overall, I'd say it's pretty okay as an all-in-one package and almost replaces the home console. There's definitely some things about it that are a little bit annoying and quirky, as almost anything from a brand new games console developer. That's right, I'd kind of consider Oculus a games console developer at this point. And there's not every single experience on the platform, obviously, because the processing power is so small and held up inside the headset. It's not as strong as something like an actual PC, so it can't render out as beautiful scenes as an actual PC could, but it can do some pretty cool stuff in and of its own right. And if you've never experienced VR before, it's pretty cool, but definitely developers are going to have to make some kind of dumbed-down versions or some mobile versions to push for an Oculus Quest store. We've already seen this with stuff such as Pavlov, stuff such as VR Chat, where there's two separate versions, one that's used on the PC and other headsets, and one that's specifically made for the Oculus Quest 2. And when you can create cross-platform capabilities, that's really, really amazing. It's definitely very limiting, but if you're looking to have a VR experience, play a few VR games, a lot of VR games are available on this headset. Five Nights at Freddy's, Population 1, a lot of the titles that you think about when you think about VR are here. Now, some of them are missing, such as VR Half-Life. That's obviously missing because that's a Valve title. They'd like to keep it on the Steam store. Plus, also, I don't think that they could actually make a dumbed-down version of the Source 2 engine. That would be so dumb that it could work on as small of a processor, so it's just kind of such a spaghetti code as it is. But overall, this almost replaces the home console, The reason that I say almost once again is because the biggest thing holding it back has to be the Facebook verification. I don't have any problem with needing to give my name to Oculus in order to use their systems. I don't really care that much. I'm not, like, worried about them taking my information or anything of that degree. But it's a little bit annoying that you can't have multiple users on the same headset. If you could, this would pretty much just be a home console that would kind of replace an Xbox or a PlayStation in someone's household. There's enough titles on here that are interesting enough that I feel like it would suffice that use for a lot of people. Other than that, the fact that it's really, really quick and simple and fast to get into a game is absolutely crazy. If you end up taking off the headset and leaving all the base settings in terms of like power usage and stuff, if you end up taking the headset, putting it down, it'll turn off the display and stuff and not use up any power. But if you instantly want to get back in your game, if you start picking up your controllers and stuff and putting it back on your headset, by the time the headset is actually situated on your head and you're all ready to go, the game's already running and it's ready to go. It's really, really fast. I got the smaller 64GB version. I am not even close to running out of storage. Obviously, I didn't install any big games. I've only installed a few demos and stored a lot of videos. But man, oh man, this seems like a really, really nice product to get, even if you don't have a nice PC to hook it up to. Just $300, here's a VR experience. You can play poker on it, you can play VR chat on it, you can play all these other games. Yeah, you're gonna have to buy a lot of the software, but man, oh man, it really is a pretty convincing package, and I would definitely suggest picking one up if you don't currently own a headset. If you do own a headset, then I wouldn't say it's really worth it, but it is a very interesting offer, and just has a lot of capabilities in it. There's definitely a lot of things holding it back. I definitely didn't buy it to just use their system. I'm gonna almost always plug it into my PC in some way, or use Virtual Desktop, which is a $20 application that lets me virtually stream my desktop into my headset. I'm always gonna use one of those two options to actually play most VR titles, so let's talk about that next. So anyway, now I'm going to be talking about the Steam side of things. At least I'm going to be talking about Steam because that's the platform that I personally use. Oculus also does have their own PC store where you can buy their games on it. You even get a free copy of a PC Oculus game when you buy the headset, or at least with the offer that I got when I bought it at the time when I bought it. It's not an amazing title, it's not a terrible title. It was pretty cool, I played through it, it was alright. But what's really interesting is all the games on the Steam Marketplace, the Steam Store, because Steam Store obviously has a ton of games. Almost any developer can put a game on the Steam Store. So there's a lot of VR titles out there, and a lot of them are extremely interesting and extremely cool. I haven't personally gotten a chance to play Half-Life VR, which is obviously the big title that I want to play, because I love Source games, I love Half-Life games, all that type of nonsense. I haven't been able to play it yet, I just haven't decided to buy it yet. I will be buying it during the winter sale, and I'll probably be doing a sit-down with SirGoldalot episode on it. I'll probably have that be my first VR sit-down with SirGoldalot, but we'll see, maybe not. I don't know fully how I'm going to do that game, because I want to play through the entire game. I feel like it'd be kind of cool if I showed you guys the entire game. I don't quite know how I'm going to tackle that one in terms of creating interesting content for you guys. But in terms of other VR titles, there's a lot of awesome, great VR titles. For example, another one made by Valve, The Lab, is an awesome introductory game into VR. Really, if this was the experience that most people got when they first played VR, it would be really, really cool. There are like a few problems with it. It has menu buttons, and it kind of feels gimmicky sometimes, and there's loading screens. But other than that, The Lab is a really, really awesome introductory VR experience. All the little game modes are really, really cool. All the little environments that you go to, and it always has that, you know, Valve touch. Every single character has an extra voice line or two than they probably should. There's always a little sound effect happening here, something in the background happening there. There's always little stories to find, you know, all the classic stuff of a Valve title. And another Valve title is Steam VR Home. Yes, the Steam VR Home isn't really a game, as much as it's just kind of a place for you to launch games and stuff, but you can have your own environments. Every single week there's new geocaches, which essentially just gives you a random location / I think they call it destination in Steam VR Home. You go to that destination, you find an item, and all it is just a hat or a prop that you can put into your house or you can put on your character. It's nothing much, but it kind of gives you something to do. Some of the areas are fictional areas, some of them are actually just real scanned in areas, so it's always kind of cool just to go into Steam VR Home, check out what spaces are around. For example, one time for one geocache, I had to go to CP Orange, and going to CP Orange was really surreal, right? I've played on CP Orange before, but actually playing it in VR was something completely different, something completely original, and was really, really, really cool. Other than that, obviously, I haven't gone to any, like, real-life place in VR that I've personally been to in real life, so I can't, obviously, tell you how surreal it is to, you know, experience, for example, Stonehenge in real life versus in VR. But, you know, visiting these real-life places is definitely kind of interesting. Sometimes it's kind of weird and gimmicky, and you're like, is this a real place? You know, in terms of, like, you have no real basis for it. But SteamVR Home is definitely a very interesting game. But obviously, it's not going to give you miles and miles and miles of traction. I played a little bit of the Steam version of Pavlov. It was obviously dramatically better than the Oculus version of Pavlov, but it wasn't that much better. Overall, in terms of using Steam VR with this specific headset, with the Oculus Quest 2, the experience of linking them up isn't beautiful. As I talked about when I was doing the unboxing, I got a $20 cable from Anchor, which is just a third-party cable seller. And yeah, it was pretty okay. It worked pretty fast. I didn't see any delays. It was only 10 feet though, so I couldn't really get up out of my chair that much. It wasn't the greatest experience. The left side of the headset kind of felt weighted down because it was connected by a wire. Obviously, there's probably better wires that you can get for that. But in terms of doing it wirelessly, I found actually a really, really great way to do it wirelessly, which is through Virtual Desktop, which is a application that you can get on the Oculus store in your headset. It costs around $20, so it's the exact same price point as getting the wire. And then all you have to do is just get the streaming desktop application on your desktop, as well as also get a side-loaded version of the application. It's not too complicated. There's already tons of tutorials out there. I'm not going to give you guys a tutorial on it. But for about the same amount of money as just getting a $20, like, 10-foot cable, it's wireless, it's much faster resolution, much higher frequency, and yes, it does kind of stutter every once in a while. And I would not recommend using it from a different network, like remoting into it from a different Wi-Fi connection. But if you're on the same Wi-Fi connection as the same PC, then you really shouldn't have any issues. It works pretty well, works pretty flawlessly. And the best part is, especially for me, since I have my PC in my living room, and my bedroom is where I have a crap ton of space, I can just go to my back room, and I have all that space to work with, and it's just really, really nice having a whole bunch of space to work around within VR. And having to be so far away from my PC is just so nice, and it's really, really awesome experience not having to be tethered to pretty much anything, which is definitely one of the biggest advantages of the Oculus Quest 2 currently in the market, is that, you know, the base operating system doesn't mean that you have to be tethered, and with Virtual Desktop, it means also I don't have to be tethered to anything, and I get to experience VR in my way, which is really, really cool. Overall, though, something that VR in general, especially PC VR, is like kind of missing is just, at least for me, that game that, you know, I can just constantly come back to, that's constantly fun to play. I'm talking stuff like, you know, Team Fortress 2, like MOBA type titles. There's just something that is multiplayer driven and is just consistently fun to come back to. Don't get me wrong, I like Pavlov. Pavlov's fun. I like playing their Search and Destroy game mode. I like playing their like TTT game mode. It's all fun, but there's no real reason to keep on coming back. There's no game that's just getting constantly supported in terms of online play that's interesting and deep enough for me yet. The closest thing is what I was talking about with Steam VR Home and collecting all the geocaching. But you know, you kind of just do your weekly little items and then you're kind of done. You don't really know what to do next. That's the biggest thing that VR is really missing for me in terms of my actual usage of VR. I'll be honest, like VR, I've played obviously Project Cars 2 in VR. But since then, I've played it without VR, and I still prefer it without VR. I still prefer it on the flat screen, firstly, because it's a little bit faster to set up, you know, than getting the headset on, making sure it's powered, all that type of stuff. But also, it's not even the motion sickness. I just personally enjoy playing on the flat screen better than having all the stuff around me. I feel, not necessarily more immersed, but I feel like I can just play the game better. So even when it comes down to games that I do already enjoy, right, Project Cars 2 was a game that I already enjoyed, I found VR didn't necessarily 100% change it. So in terms of my personal usage of VR and how I think a lot of people will be using it who are using it for games, VR will still be kind of a gimmick. And you'll just kind of have the headset there so that way when there is a VR title that you care about, you can play it. You're not trying to necessarily become a VR-only gamer. I don't personally see myself doing that anytime soon. I think VR will still stay in the realm of gimmicks when it comes to the gaming market. But in terms of the consumer market and more consumers getting their hands on VR, I still think that consumers, like general consumers who don't consider themselves gamers, for say, are still going to be kind of viewing it as a gimmick, and they'll be using it once or twice a week, possibly, and then forgetting about it for entire weeks at a time. And you know what? back when headsets were $500, $600, $700 just to get like a mid-range to low-range headset, and you also had to have a gaming PC, that was outrageous. That's when it was not consumer viable. It just wasn't, because you're only going to use it a few times. But you look at something like, for example, Nintendo Switch. I've been in a very similar boat with my Nintendo Switch time and time again. I'll play a few games on it, I'll have fun with it for a few weeks, and then I'll just kind of forget that it exists for a few weeks, and then I'll end up refining it, replaying Smash Brothers, whatever it is. And when you look at that compared to now a $400 headset, or $300 in my case, it's really not that unreasonable for a general consumer who doesn't consider themselves an extreme gamer or anything, just buying the Oculus Quest 2, using its onboard software, buying a few games that they think are interesting, and then, you know, once they get kind of tired with VR, just kind of putting it necessarily on like a bureau or something, forgetting about it for a few weeks, and picking it back up. And finally, at this price point, that finally seems like something that's really, really viable for people to do, as well as for me personally. And I'm not going to be, you know, suddenly playing VR titles exclusive, as I said before, but it's really, really nice having that confidence where if I hear about a new cool title that's going to be in virtual reality, I'm not going to be like, oh, shucks, wish I had a headset. I'm now in a position where it's like, oh, okay, cool. I have it. I have that capability. I have the ability to do that in the same way where I could never imagine myself being a person who plays games, for example, on like a laptop or something, and then hearing about a cool new game and being like, well, shucks, too bad I don't have any like computer that has a like graphical processor in it. I have a GPU in my computer, which means I can play most modern titles that come out. I can't play them necessarily with the highest of settings, but it's just really nice having that confidence, not having to worry about when I hear about a cool new game being like, oh, am I even going to be able to play it? So that's definitely, I think, the biggest appeal for people who watch this channel who don't necessarily already have a VR headset. If you're looking into getting a headset, it's $300 to get the freedom and like just like the knowledge of knowing, okay, cool, I'm not going to have to worry about not enjoying games in the future. If you're someone who just sticks to one game and you play it over and over and over again, then I don't think that this is necessarily a product that is meant for you, at least not at this price point. If it ever gets below $300 somehow, then maybe it's more respectable for you. But overall, I'm extremely happy with my purchase. I think it works wonderfully, and I'm really, really glad at how it works in terms of plugging into my PC and stuff and getting it to work with my PC. It's something going to be a product that I'm going to continue to use, and definitely it's something that you, and I feel like most consumers, should definitely consider getting. It's definitely a worthwhile product. Final thoughts on VR? It's pretty epic, bros. That's right, you heard it here first. It's really epic. It's really epic going to virtual spaces that you already know, getting to revisit them. It's really cool getting to go to brand new virtual spaces that you've never seen before. I do think this technology is going to enter a lot of people's lives who aren't even gamers over the next few years, and it's going to improve a lot of people's lives, similar to something like microwaves and television, and it's going to get into more people's hands the cheaper and cheaper the technology gets. I think it's pretty cool. I don't think it's going to replace the way that I play video games, though, that's for sure. But overall, it was mega cool, and you should definitely experience it for yourself. You should definitely get yourself your own headset. In terms of some of my favorite experiences, I liked a lot of the free demos that were available on Oculus Quest 2, just because I got to experience so many different things. I liked Project Cars 2, but that's because I already liked the game, and I like racing games already as it is. I liked poker, but once again, it's because I already like poker. I'm sure you'll find some games that you like. I'm sure that whatever genre you like, there's a version of it in VR, surely out there. Overall, though, I gotta walk around as Peter Griffin, doing this little puzzle thing. I gotta play card games inside a virtual home of mine. It was pretty cool and epic, bros. Also, this video took so damn long to make. It took me 2 total weeks of making it, but this is by far the most time in those weeks that I've spent making a video. It took me a really long time to make it. It'd mean a lot if you guys like, subscribe, do that, all that good, crazy nonsense. I love you guys. Have a great and awesome day.